So the ocean shader is one of my, it's probably my single favorite shader that Logan made for the game. And it is very robust, and we use a lot of variants for different things in the solar system. So I'll talk about the ocean first, because that was sort of the template that, you know, when we were rebooting art, we used Giant's Deep as like a vertical slice, and we were like, okay, we need to have cool looking water to sell the planet, because that's most of what you see. And so we made the shader, and then I was like, hey, what if we hijacked it and did this with it? And Logan was like, oh, that's a good idea. And so we ended up using it all over the place. So the way the ocean shader works is this sphere is technically a cube. And it's hard to show because I would have to like edit the shader code, and I'm not a programmer, so I don't know how to do that. But essentially the way it works is there's a cube that then gets projected into the shape of a sphere. And that allows us to do height map stuff, which I said we couldn't do because everything's on spheres. But Logan created a clever workaround where we take this cube and snap it to a sphere. And so then we can tile square textures along it to create this height map blend. And I'll show you how we do that. So we have our surface shader here, which has got a lot of stuff going on. It's got some standard shader stuff like, you know, color and smoothness and all that. But the ocean itself is made up of these four height maps. And each one of the height maps is actually four height maps in one. So you can see RGBA here. We use each of the four channels for a different grayscale height map. And so we have different scales of them, essentially. So there's like these really tiny waves that you can see on the surface. There's big chunkier waves that create like the patterns overall. And essentially each channel is faded one to the other over time. So it'll like be red for a second, and then green for a second, then blue, then alpha, and then it'll loop back around. And then meanwhile, we have control over how fast these scroll across the surface, how much they displace the verts of the sphere, and like the time scale and some offset stuff so that it doesn't look super repeated. Another nice thing that makes the shader possible is that it's called the tessellated sphere renderer because it dynamically tessellates based on how close the camera is. Again, that's another thing that I can't really show without editing the shader code, but you'll just have to trust me that the ocean here is really high density. There's a lot of polygons and triangles.
Can you turn it into a shaded wireframe to perhaps maybe?
It doesn't actually work.
It doesn't
actually because of the shader.
Got it.
And I may have just, you can kind of see it.
Yeah. Oh my God, that's crazy to see.
Yeah. So you can see like over here,
yeah,
there's like lower density on the triangles.
Okay.
You can see like right there, there's a seam where it transitions from a higher poly to a lower poly.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how that works. It's much easier to see with like a grayscale, but
yeah.
So all that displacement happens on the high poly stuff that you're close to. And then it has nice like transitions so that there aren't seams. And then there's also another height map here, which we call chop. And this is specifically used in conjunction with the tornadoes. So you can see they sort of like pull the ocean up into them.
Yes.
That's basically a volume we have attached to the bottom of the tornado. And wherever that volume is, it adds the chop height map in addition to the others. And then we have the reverse as well. So for certain islands, we have calm zones that basically make the waves lower.
So if we were to hide one of the tornadoes, would it better illustrate what that chop looks like?
Yeah, I'll show the tornadoes more in a moment, but I can quickly do that. If I just turn off these meshes, turn off the top. Oh, it's not turning off. That's because I need to turn off the skinned mesh. There we go. So you can see,
oh, nice.
It's pulling the waves up. And if I grab the ocean chop zone and move it around, that's what the tornadoes are doing, is they're moving around.
Okay.
And then in addition to all that, the ocean also has foam, which you can see on the chop here, which is basically whenever the height gets above a certain level, we add this sort of white texture to it so that it becomes more opaque and doesn't look very good with the lighting off, but you can see that it adds the foam to the top there.
Yeah, it makes it more clear. You just see the black and the white of the foam.
Yep. So that's a lot of the ocean shader. Let me see if there's anything else I missed here. It's also, you know, it uses other water stuff, so it has refraction, and if you look at something close, You can see that it's refracting the stuff under the water. It's kind of hard to tell. Maybe if I grab this light and make it really bright, you can see underneath the water it's refracting, like you would expect. So, you know, in addition to all the other fancy things it does, it also is water. And something that we took the effort to do, which a lot of games try and avoid, is we actually have a stencil so you can see both above and below the water at the same time.
Oh, wow. Okay.
A lot of games, you just like pop the camera one way or the other because it's a hard thing to handle. But since Outer Wilds is so much about naturalism and like the feeling that you're actually there in your suit, we wanted to handle that so that you could, you know, feel like you're bobbing up and down the water.
And how was the effect like of being underwater achieved? Just that, was that another kind of fog that, or like, does it use a similar system as a fog? Or?
The underwater shader is probably more similar to a lot of underwater and video games. It's like a shader that, you know, renders fog and distorts things above the surface. You know, we had to make it in the shape of a sphere, which was a challenge, but in other ways it's, you know, more typical, like what you'd see in a normal video game.
And the sphere is rendered on two sides so you could see it from the bottom as well?
Yeah, the ocean surface, we have it. So yeah, when you're looking up, it also refracts above the water.